One of these men is an internationally famous hypnotist. What is your name, please?
My name is Arthur Ellen.
My name is Arthur Ellen.
My name is Arthur Ellen.
Only one of these men is the real Arthur Ellen. The other two are imposters and will try to fool this panel. Tom Poston, Betty White, Alan Ludden, and Kitty Carlisle. On to Tell the Truth with your host, Bud Collier.
Brought to you this week by Salem Cigarettes. Hi, panel.
Hello, Bud.
How are you all? For the four or maybe five people in our audience who don't know, Betty White is now Mrs. Alan Ludden.
I'm very happy about it.
Betty, how long have you been married?
3 weeks, 3 days. 4 hours and 20 minutes, approximately.
40 minutes.
I'm not going to get in on anything here. I'm going to leave that one right alone. I do know, however, that there's very good news for people who want to see you together because you're opening, it'll be tomorrow night, won't it?
Tomorrow night.
Brigadoon.
Yes, in Paterson, New Jersey.
Oh, boy.
That ought to be fun, real good fun. Would you kindly open up your envelope, take out your affidavit cards for the first time, and follow along with me as I read from my copy. All right, Tom. I, Arthur Ellen, have hypnotized more than 70,000 people during my appearances in theaters and nightclubs across the country. I am, however, just as interested in hypnotism as a science as I am in hypnotism as entertainment. The most rewarding part of my work is helping people to overcome personal habits such as fingernail biting, fear of flying, temporary laryngitis, weight control, as well as assorted apprehensions and imaginary aches and pains. Among those I have been able to help are Vic Damone, Maury Wills, George Gobel, Guy Lombardo, Jackie Jensen, Johnny Mathis, Tony Curtis, Tony Martin, Sal Magley, and Harry Belafonte. Signed, Arthur Ellen. Panel, we have here three gentlemen all claiming, as you heard, to be the same person. Arthur Ellen by name, by profession, hypnotist. And we start this first round of questioning with Tom Poston. Tom?
Oh, thank you, Bud. I'd like to ask number two, for instance, what's the purpose of that gold watch on a chain that hypnotists often use in their, at least in their act?
I guess it's for focal attention. I never use it.
What do you use, number two?
No particular device. Just try to capture attention.
Thank you. Number three, who's the first great, well-known hypnotist that we hear so much about?
Franz Anton Mesmer.
Thank you. Number one, where was he from? Where did he...
He was from Austria and practiced in France.
He was from Austria, though?
Yes.
I always thought he was a French cat. Number two, how do you know, for instance, the basic reason why someone might bite nails? Suppose, for instance, that you stopped a person from biting nails, and it was really a screen for something much more serious. Wouldn't it then turn in on the person and do him some harm?
Would you repeat that question?
See, somebody stopped me from biting my nails when I was a kid, and this is the result. But how do you know the basic reason for someone's biting nails? How can you tell just by talking to them?
Well, it probably serves some purpose, so we try to find out what it is that makes the person so sensitive that he needs a symptom at all. That's whether it's nail biting or anything else.
Betty.
Thank you, Bud. Number three, does everyone go under more or less in the same length of time?
No, it varies with the individual. It's a question of cooperation, probably.
Number two, what is the fastest you've ever put someone under hypnosis?
Probably a few seconds.
Number one, when did Maury Wills come to you?
This was in December of 62.
Of 62. Mm-hmm. Number three, what was Maury's main reason for wanting hypnosis?
Well, he had some trouble with his legs. As a matter of fact, they were hemorrhaging.
Thank you.
Alan.
Number one, did you understand Tom Poston's question?
I believe I did.
What's the answer? I didn't understand the question, but...
Which one?
That long one.
This wasn't directed to me.
I see. All right, number three. How long is the span of involuntary attention in a normal individual?
You mean under hypnosis?
No. Involuntary attention.
Well, there again, it varies with the individual. Now, children, small children, have a very short attention span.
Number two, is there for our normal adult, the involuntary attention span, how long is it? Number two.
It depends on the individual.
Kitty.
Number one, do you practice mass hypnosis?
I do this occasionally in some of my acts.
Can you manage to make a whole audience do the same thing?
No, this is very difficult. You'll probably have 10-15% of the audience.
What do you use for hypnosis, number one?
Suggestion. Usually it takes 6 to 15 seconds for
you
the majority.
You don't use a shining object?
No.
Do you, number three?
No props, no gimmicks.
Number one, can you tell me the color of Tony Curtis's eyes?
Tony Curtis's eyes are blue.
Thank you. Number three, when...
That's all the time we have, and it's just as well, I think. So, Nicole, I'll hold on further questions and just get to the business of marking your ballots. Will you do so at once, please, and without change, of course, as you vote now without consultation for number one, number two, or number three. Our team of challengers will be awarded the usual $250 for every incorrect vote. Are all ballots marked? All right, Tom, for whom did you vote?
I voted for number two. I wish that he'd been a little more straightforward in his answer about the attention span, but I dare say it does vary from person to person. It's just that he could have said something besides that, I think. But what am I knocking him for? I don't even know if he's the right one.
Betty, what is your choice?
Well, I don't think it was number two. He looks more like he'd be a gambler to me, I think. And I think it's number one because I look into his eyes and I get a very funny feeling, honey. I mean, I'll put it.
Alan?
Oh, I don't know. She shakes me so.
Well, I voted for number three because I, remembering my freshman psychology, remember that there is some variation, but there should be a standard length of involuntary attention span for adults, and he sounds like the doctor to me, the man who does it, and I'm sure I'm not right. Well, you have a choice, Kitty. You can go with one, two, or three.
I voted for number two. I liked his answer to Tom's long question, which I flatter myself I understood. I don't think he gave a complete answer, but I think he understood it, too. So I voted for number two.
Tom is laughing because even he didn't understand
it. It was an interesting lecture, though, wasn't it?
All right, there we go now. The votes are all neatly tucked away. Let's get to the polling booths and find out what the result is as we learn which one of these gentlemen actually is the professional hypnotist. So will the real Arthur Ellen please stand up?
Specific one.
It wasn't a very specific one.
It does depend on the individual, sometimes only a few seconds.
What a great gambler you'd be.
Tom, if you and Kitty would like to step out here, well, he'd be glad to...
No, it's Betty that got the look in his eye.
Can you imagine? Why? I thought it was scientific.
Can you imagine if he was a gambler, he could say, lose, lose.
Incidentally, Arthur Ellen's opening at the Sahara Hotel in Las Vegas next week, so run out there and see him. How about these other two gentlemen? Number one, what is your real name and what do you really do, sir?
My name is John Warrell, and I'm associated with the Norelco Hearing Aid Division of North American Phillips.
And number three, you also got a vote. What is your real name, sir, and what do you do?
My name is Douglas Andrews, and I am Eastern Advertising Manager for Air Force Magazine.
Fine, of course, there were two incorrect votes. And at $250 each, gentlemen, that's $500 you take away with you from Salem Cigarettes, as well, of course, as a carton of Salem's on your way out. And our thanks to you for being with us and hope you had as good a time as we did. Good night. God bless you.
Now, everyone, let's relax for just a minute and take a look at this delightful film and discover a new world of springtime. Now, panel, let's meet our next team of challengers.
What is your name, please?
My name is Jean McCarg.
My name is Jean McCarg.
My name is Jean McCarg.
Panel, will you follow along with your copies of this affidavit as I read? I, Jean McCarg, own and operate an employment agency exclusively for cowboys. Each year, I find jobs for more than 5,000 of them on ranches in 49 states. I advertise my services in The Western Horseman, The Record Stockman, and in Hoofs and Horns. If you are looking for work, I can find you a job, provided you are a qualified cow waddy, buckaroo, top hand, chore man, ramrod, or even a string twanger. Signed, Gene McCarg. Now we have three ladies all claiming to be Jean McCarg, who is the finder of jobs for cowboys. Betty Ludden. Betty, suppose you start.
In other words, I'm in the shoot anyway. Number three, what's the difference between a cow waddy and a string twanger?
Well, they're both cowboys. One of them's had a little more experience.
Which one?
The cow waddy.
Number two, what is a cow waddy?
Cow puncher.
Number one, what's a string twanger?
The string twanger is someone who plays a guitar or plays some sort of music.
First, I'd like to sing a little song. Number two, where is your base of operation?
Denver, Colorado.
Number three, where is your base of operation?
Dodge City, Kansas.
I knew it, and I'm number one. Where is your base of operation?
Spokane, Washington.
What is the state, number three, that uses the fewest of your clientele?
The state of Maine and Delaware uses very few.
Thank you.
Alan.
Well, that's what I was going to ask.
I'm sorry.
49 states. What state has never used your services at all?
Which one? Which number? Number three.
The state of Maine and...
The state of Maine doesn't use... When you say that a string twanger, number two, a string twanger, is that a qualification for a cowboy these days?
It helps.
Number one, most of your jobs on dude ranches?
Part of them are dude ranches, working cattle ranches, any place where you need a cowboy or any reasonable facsimile.
Kitty.
I think this is a fantastic record, 5,000 cowboys, my goodness. Number one, do you know where Valley Ranch is?
Yes, I do.
Where is it?
Out of Cody, about 45 miles.
Thank you. Number two, what is a wrangler?
He works with horses.
Number three, do the cowboys have unions?
No.
Number one, what is the average pay for an experienced cowboy?
It depends. A ramrod...
What is a ramrod?
Well, he's exactly that. He's a foreman, really.
He's
a head man.
What would he get?
It ranges from $300 to $800 a month. It's a variable thing, depending on requirements.
Number two, do you agree with this?
Yes.
Tom.
Thank you, Bud. Number three, what is a remuda?
It's a cow.
Number two, what is a pig and string?
Something a cowboy carries in his teeth.
As a regular thing, you mean?
No, just on certain jobs.
Thank you. Well, all right, all right. Number two, what's a tailgate?
The back end of a truck.
Thank you. Number one, you know where that ranch is in Cody. Do you know where Sebo's place is in Illinois?
Yes, I do.
Where is Sebo's spread?
It's out of Decatur.
Thank you.
And that's all the time we have. So get up on them cow ponies and swing your lariats around and zero in on some votes, will you please? Vote right now without change and no consultation permitted as you're voting, as you know, for number one, for number two, or number three. All set, everybody? Okay. Tom, for whom did you vote?
I voted for number two. And It's funny because I was going to vote, well, a remuda, of course, is like a bunch of horses, but the working stock that's used at that particular time, but I was going to vote for number one, except that I asked her where Sebo's place was, and he's watching the show right now. He's a lawyer friend of mine.
Oh, no!
In Canton, Illinois. So I had to vote for number two.
Oh,
I'm sorry. She took me so much by surprise. You have no idea how she let the wind out of me because I was going to vote for her, and I just asked her, so
it's
she'd say no.
Fair.
And she went, yes, I do.
Betty.
You have an eraser. I still think it's number one because I still think there's a Sebo's place out of Decatur because I have faith. That's what I have.
Well, she's beautiful.
I've been taken, too.
Mr. White? Alan?
Thank you. Now I feel better. I was going to vote for number two because I liked the way she answered about the tailgate. That I understood. But then I liked the authority that number one had for Sebo's place.
All right, Kitty, what is your vote?
My vote. I voted for number one because she did know where Valley Ranch was, and it is 45 minutes outside of Cody, and I was there last summer. And I don't give a darn about Sebo.
I hope it's one. I hope it's one.
Well, I'm not going to waste any time on getting the truth in this one. Let's get right at it and find out which of these ladies it is that finds jobs for cowboys. So, Will the Real, Jean McCarg, please stand up.
With two.
I wish we could spend more time on it, but we can't. I'm sorry. We can't dig into it now. The time's running along so fast. We'll find out later. Number one, you got most of the Sebos.
I have
What is your real name and what do you really do?
My name is Caroline Rogers, and I'm an associate editor at the Reader's Digest.
You are the great
one. Well, good actress. Number three, what is your real name and what do you do?
Beulah Mitchell, and I'm a graduate nurse.
Well, we thank you all. And I want you to know that Mrs. Sebo's here did a good job for you. Because three incorrect votes at $250 each, that's $750, ladies. Look at the sparkles light up in your eyes on that one. That comes to you, of course, from Salem Cigarettes, as does a carton of Salem's on your way out, and our sincere thanks. Hope you had as much fun as we did. Good night. God bless you. Seconds are guaranteed to put you in a refreshing frame of mind. Watch. Meet our third team of challengers.
What is your name, please?
My name is John D. Schrott, Jr.
My name is John D. Schrott, Jr.
My name is John D. Schrott, Jr.
Panel, will you follow along with your copies of this affidavit? I, John D. Schrott, Jr., advise people on investing. I am director in charge of financial affairs for an institute of technology, a lecturer on investing to a group of employees of a large federal agency, and chairman of the junior advisory board of a savings and loan association. I have also done rather well in investing on my own. I talk to my broker for at least 15 minutes every day. Last week, I had a meeting with Mr. Bruce Cobden, special assistant to the president of the New York Stock Exchange. I plan to continue with my career in the stock market when I graduate from high school. Signed, John D. Schrott, Jr. Very well, these three gentlemen all claim to be John D. Schrott, Jr., teenage stock market expert. Let's start with Kitty Carlisle. Kitty?
Thank you, Bud. Number one, if you're a bear, do you sell short or long?
Could you repeat that, please?
If you're a bear, do you sell short or long? Is it short? Yeah.
Long.
Long.
Right.
If you're a bear.
Right.
Number two, if you're a bull, do you sell when it's going up or down?
You sell when it's going up.
You sell when it's going down if you're a bull.
You're going to sell when it's going up.
If you're a bull.
Right.
Number three, are visitors to the stock exchange allowed on the floor?
Not usually.
Number one, what is the name of your brokerage firm?
Kidder Peabody and Company.
Number two, have you got any hot tips?
Yes.
No.
Tom Poston's a hot tip, Tom.
Thank you. Number two, why did you pronounce your name differently? Let's pronounce your name again.
Shrout.
Shrout. Number three, you said Shrout. You want to fight about it, you guys?
No.
And I don't know what I'm supposed to make out of that. Shrout. Why did you meet with Mr. Cobden?
Why did I meet with him? Well, I was taking a tour of the New York Stock Exchange today, and the past couple of days I've been down there, and I met with him so he could arrange the tour.
Oh, is that? Oh, I see.
Betty.
Thank you, Bud. Number two, what's the difference between common and preferred stock?
Common stock has not quite as much value when they distribute the dividends. Preferred stock gets all dividends first.
Number three, what constitutes gilt edge stock security?
They're usually better stocks than others.
And number one, how many would you say in the vast number of stocks would be classified as gilt edge?
I can't answer that.
That's right, because I can't even ask it.
Alan. Number three, what's the difference between the American, what's the essential difference between the American and the New York Stock Exchanges?
I believe that it's in the manner of trading.
Number one, do you agree with that?
Yes, I do.
Number two.
Yes, I do.
Number three, what are the, how many blue chip stocks as such would you say there are?
I wouldn't know.
Number one, do you know if there's a number?
No, I don't know.
Number two, how do you define a blue chip stock?
A blue chip stock has more security in it. Fluctuate less.
Number three, how many stocks does a mutual fund usually invest in?
There's no set amount.
How many? And that's it. I'm sorry we had such a brief time. We had so much fun before, we didn't leave enough time for this one, really. But there it is. What information you have. Mark your ballots now, if you will, without change and no consultation permitted. Voting as you go for number one, number two, or number three. All ballots are marked. So, Tom, for whom did you vote?
I voted for number three. I thought bulls bought. But I may be wrong.
Betty.
Well, I voted for number two. The Shrout and Shrout bothered me a little bit, but if you play flute, you're a flautist, so that didn't help me at all. And I didn't think it was number one because he said he just had the meeting, and the affidavit says the meeting with Mr. Cobden was over a week ago. So between the other two, number three gave me a nice, direct, honest smile. I think it's number two.
Because Alan. Number three gave you an honest smile?
Don't argue with the people.
All right. I voted for number three because I thought bulls bought, too. I don't mean to agree with Tom Poston on anything, but in this case, I did.
Kitty.
I voted for number two because number two told me that bulls do buy, and also his eyes are bad because he's been bending over the ticker too long.
Well, the gentlemen are together and the ladies are together on this one. Two for three, two for two. Let's go for it now and find out which of these gentlemen actually is the teenage stock market expert. So will the real John D. Shrout Jr. please stand up.
Yeah.
Looks like the man had the answer on that one. Number one, what is your real name and what do you really do?
My name is Jerry Mack, and I'm a senior at Xavier High School here in New York.
Congratulations.
Good job,
and number two, what is your real name and what do you really do?
My name is Richard Williams, and I'm a lifeguard at Motel City in New York.
Checking the score, we find that there were two incorrect votes, and that's not bad. That's two times $250, $500 from Salem Cigarettes and a carton of Salem's on your way out. And our thanks to you, fellas. Hope you had a good time. Good night, and God bless you. Now, here's how you can get relief of headache pain. Kitty, Alan, yeah. Betty, do you realize that Tom got all three right?
Yeah.
Oh, we're not thinking yeah. to him.
Oh, well, what the heck?
What did he do last week?
It isn't how you play the game,
last week,
win or lose.
That's right.
How did you, how many did you get last week?
This week it was nothing. Last week, zero.
All right, whatever it was, you're always great, every one of you, and I love you. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye. Thanks for being your own sweet selves. Don't forget to join us at the same time next week, and of course, I'll be with you tomorrow afternoon on the daytime show. In the meantime, Bud Collier saying goodnight. Salem Cigarettes and reminding you to tell the truth. Good night, everybody.
To Tell the Truth is a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Tonight by Salem, the cigarette that refreshes your taste. Johnny Olson speaking for To Tell the Truth. This program was pre-recorded.